Hello, and welcome to the video for the TI Precision Lab discussing electrical overstress, or EOS, Part 4. In this video, we will cover how a device is damaged by the most common types of harmful electrical transients and the standard tests which are used to determine a product's robustness against these transients. So how does a typical device become damaged? Let's look at an example with a typical op-amp. The triggering of the device's ESD protection cells is the primary issue with exceeding the op-amp's absolute maximum ratings. The schematic shown here depicts a generalized input-output, or I/O, pad with ESD protection in the form of clamping diodes. If a voltage excursion with high enough voltage and current occurs on the I/O pad, these diodes can forward conduct. Depending on the severity and frequency of these excursions, the clamps can fail over time. This is just one example of how a device can become damaged. Of course, end equipment manufacturers typically want to create products which are as robust as possible and react to transient energy in a predictable way. To do this, products are tested in advance under harsh electrical conditions which simulate the real world. The IEC is a worldwide organization which promotes international cooperation on issues of standardization in electrical and electronic systems. They have developed a set of transient and EMI immunity standards, which have become the minimum requirements for manufacturers wanting to do business in the European community and around the world. The standards which are applicable to many electronic circuits are known as IEC 61000-4. In general, how well a circuit performs against these test standards is referred to as its electromagnetic compatibility, or EMC, and the process of testing to these standards is called EMC testing. In this video, we'll focus on the tests for transient energy, specifically ESD, EFT, and surge. Several types of EMC certification test methods exist. For a product to achieve official certification with the IEC, it must undergo formal testing performed by a third party. A less stringent type of testing is called an engineering evaluation, where the circuit designer performs the tests themselves. Testing is typically done at an accredited test center, which provides the standardized equipment to generate and apply the variety of transients. It's important to note that the circuit designer is able to define what limits make up a pass or fail condition. A circuit will achieve one out of four classes of performance during the suite of tests. For Class A, the circuit performance remains within the specified limits during the test. For Class B, the circuit performance temporarily falls outside the limits but recovers on its own after the test ends. For Class C, the circuit performance falls outside the limits but recovers after intervention such as a power cycle or register rewrite. For Class D, the circuit performance or function fails permanently, either due to hardware damage or loss of data. Electrostatic discharge, or ESD, is one of the most common forms of transients in electronic systems. ESD results from conditions which allow the buildup of electrical charge from contact and separation of two non-conductive materials. When the charged body is brought in proximity of another object of lower potential, energy is released in the form of ESD. ESD is standardized in IEC 61000-4-2. This standard gives the parameters of the current waveform associated with the ESD event, as well as the time between ESD events or test pulses. Of course, the standard also provides the maximum charge voltage given in kilovolts, or kV. Four different threat levels are defined, which depend on ambient humidity, material type, and expected amount of handling. Level 1 is the least severe, while level 4 is the most severe. During the set of ESD tests, transient energy is discharged onto the circuit under test in several ways. In air discharge, ESD is discharged 10 times, approximately 1 centimeter from the device under test. In contact discharge, the tip of the ESD generator is placed in contact with the device under test. ESD is again discharged 10 times. In indirect discharge to the vertical coupling plane, or VCP, the device under test is placed 10 centimeters away from a vertically oriented metal plane. ESD is discharged 10 times to the side of the plane. An indirect discharge to the horizontal coupling plane, or HCP, the device under test is placed on an insulating mat, which is on a table with a horizontal metal plane. ESD is discharged 10 times on the side of the plane. These photos show several of the ESD test configurations. The left photo shows discharge into a vertical coupling plane. The center photo shows discharge into a horizontal coupling plane. Finally, the right photo shows air discharge. Electrical fast transients, or EFT, occur as a result of arcing contacts in switches and relays, and are very common in industrial environments using electromechanical switches to connect and disconnect inductive loads. EFT is standardized in IEC 61000-4-4. The EFT waveform is described in terms of a voltage across a 50-ohm load from a generator having a nominal dynamic source impedance of 50 ohms. The output occurs as a burst of high voltage spikes at a repetition rate ranging from 2 kHz to 5 kHz. The burst length is defined as 15 milliseconds with bursts repeated every 300 milliseconds. Each individual burst pulse has a rise time of 5 nanoseconds and a total duration of 50 nanoseconds. IEC 61000-4-4 specifies the EFT threat in both power and data lines in terms of open circuit voltage and short circuit current. Four levels are defined, where level 1 is the least severe and level 4 is the most severe. During the EFT test, the device under test is connected to its power supply with 3 meters of cable and placed on a small wooden platform. Part of the cable passes through a special trough with wooden side panels and a triangular metallic inner chamber. The EFT generator is connected to the metallic chamber of the trough, and the test waveform is applied. The EFT waveform can then couple to the device under test's power supply cable. The most severe transient conditions on power and data lines are surges caused by lightning strikes and switching. Switching transients include power system switching, load changes, and short circuit faults. Lightning transients may result from a direct strike or induced voltages and currents due to an indirect strike. Surge is standardized in IEC 61000-4-5, which defines a transient entry point and a set of installation conditions. The transient is defined in terms of a generator producing a given waveform and having a specified open circuit voltage and source impedance. Two surge waveforms are specified, which are representative of industrial equipment. The 1.2 by 50 microseconds open circuit voltage waveform and the 8 by 20 microsecond short circuit current waveform. IEC 61000-4-5 specifies the surge threat for the power supply, data bus, and any other lines which interface to the outside world. Maximum voltages and currents are given for both line-to-line and line-to-ground coupling modes. Five levels are defined, where level 1 is the least severe and level 5 is the most severe. For the surge test, the device under test is placed on a small wooden platform and connected to its power supply through a robust LC filter network. The surge generator is connected to the capacitors of the LC filter, allowing the device under test to be exposed to surge conditions while protecting the power supply. The surge voltage is tested at both positive and negative polarities. Connections are made using all possible combinations across the device under test's power supply terminals, both differentially and common mode. Here we compare the pulse power of the EFT and surge transients with the power caused by an ESD transient. Right away, it's clear from the plot on the left that the energy of surge and EFT is orders of magnitude larger than the energy of ESD. In the plot on the bottom right, a 10 kilovolt ESD transient is represented by the small blue pulse in the bottom left corner. EFT has several times more pulse power, and a 500 volt surge has even more power over a much longer time interval. This type of surge is representative of factory environments in industrial and process automation. The plot on the top right shows the enormous power of a 6 kilovolt surge transient, which typically occurs in e-metering applications with power generating and power grid systems. Note that the unit of the pulse power changes from kilowatts to megawatts, causing the 500 volt surge to nearly disappear. We offer several TI precision designs, which include extra protection components to ensure robustness against the harmful transients discussed in this video. For these designs, engineering evaluation EMC tests are performed, and the results are given in the appendix of the design document. Component selection and the reasoning behind the overall protection scheme are also provided. One excellent example of this kind of design is TIPD153, an isolated single-channel industrial voltage and current output driver. Another great example of a circuit which is well protected and tested for EMC is TIPD158, a low-cost loop-powered 4 to 20 milliamp transmitter. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of this video's content.